It was a long, unruly 12-hour drive. We left Illinois at 6 in the morning and spent the whole day traveling across Wisconsin and Minnesota. We breathed a sigh of relief when we arrived in Duluth, still 2 hours from our destination. However, as we passed under CN's ore dock, we saw 3 CN units sitting directly above us. We knew then that this trip was bound to be something special. It was. This is the story of our week. Before we even arrived at our destination, we chased a northbound manifest from Virginia up to South Britt Siding. The first official train of the trip is a CN-100 anniversary unit. This would not be the last one either. The next day, we went up to South Haley Siding, where we caught 3 trains. Later, we went up to Ray, where we narrowly caught this southbound Q train. Also, there was a kayak strapped to the front of the second locomotive. To this day, we still don't know why. We came back down to Cusson, where we caught a northbound intermodal, then chased it up to North Ash Lake. Last two trains of the day, we caught two northbounds in Angora and Cook. By this time, storms were coming towards us and we didn't feel like braving them, even though we ended up having to on the way back to the cabin.
109.6.
Next day, we began in Gien, where we caught the northbound local heading to Rannell.
09.6. Northbound, no defects. Temperature 5.6F. Total axles 2.3.6. Speed 3.1. Detector out.
We went a bit farther north to Orr, where we caught this southbound, and eventually, the northbound local again. We headed far south, down to Mount Iron, where we caught this northbound ore train on the Mintac line.
Thank you.
trekked a bit farther south to Iron Junction for this northbound intermodal on the Mesabe Sub. Iron Junction, we followed the road farther south to Zim in order to get two northbounds.
But there's a work block on the Mintac sub, so we're probably in no hurry if you're working in front of us over here.
After Zim, we went to Forbes and got two more northbounds, one led by a CN 15th anniversary unit. After Forbes, we went to Keenan, where we caught two southbounds, one of which, well, you'll see. Our last train of the day was this southbound at North Virginia. Following day, we started with the southbound in Cook. Next, we caught this northbound just around the corner from Minorca Junction.
North on the approach to spread out.
We chased this southbound east on the Iron Range sub to Sparta. We went over to the Misabe sub to Saks, where we caught this northbound. We went way south to Proctor and caught this northbound at Stark Road. Next, we went to Thompson Hill in Duluth for this southbound heading down the hill to the Hallett Dock, near CN's ore docks. We chased it down the hill to Misabe Junction. Next, we went over to Beck's Road Overpass for this northbound climbing the massive grade up Steelton Hill. Later, we went a bit east on Beck's Road to Gary XO, a control point on the Superior sub in the foreground of Eli's Peak.
Thank you.
We went north of Proctor to Seville Road, where we caught two trains meeting, both with old EMD power. Following the rainy sub back north, we caught two southbounds at Maple Grove Road and Whiteface.
Thank you.
We begin the next day with a treat. For 10 minutes, we pace this southbound leaving South Ash Lake.
Thank you.
Next, we caught this northbound weed sprayer train in Orr. Then we went south to Angora and caught a northbound sand train. We went farther south to Shelton Junction for this one southbound, then to Iron Junction, where we caught a whopping 8 trains in about an hour.
Thank you. Thank you.
We went back up to Shelton Junction for one more southbound, then to Gein for the southbound return of the weed sprayer. Started the following day at South Haley for the southbound. We then went up to Orr for a northbound and North Ash Lake for a southbound. finished the day with this northbound train at Ray. Next day we spent on the CN Sprague sub between Baudette and Warroad, Minnesota. Since I've already uploaded a video on that, I will not include those trains here. However, we still caught this southbound local on our way there. Final day of our trip, we start off in Superior, Wisconsin, where we caught this BNSF local at Winter Street. Closed out the Railfanning portion of our trip by heading south to Oliver and Saunders Junction, where we caught several trains coming in and out of Pokegama Yard. Thank you.
time, you know. I hate when I get caught by that doggone train.
What?
What are you all doing?
Filming.